Okay, good afternoon, grade 10s. Good afternoon, everyone. Hello, 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 hello. Hello, I can see Lionheart is here. Jaden is here. And I can see, let me see, Lionheart, Nelly Blessed. Hello, guys, how are you? I hope you are well. Let's see. Hello, hello. Good afternoon. Okay, so I think we should start now. All right. So yesterday we talked about networks. So yesterday was an introduction to networks, even though our session didn't end the way I wanted it to end. Okay, things didn't go the way I planned them. All right, so for today, I am Izel Sithole, but you can call me Miss or Ma'am Sithole. All right, so I'm your CAD teacher. For those who are, if it's your first time here, I am Miss Sithole, your new CAD teacher. Yesterday was our first session with you guys. Right, so this is our second. So yesterday we were talking about networks. So it was an introduction to networks. So today we are going to focus on the advantages and the disadvantages of networks. If I can ask you, what do we mean by networks? Network, guys. Networks. Remember we said a network is a system of interconnected computers. When two or more computers are connected and they share devices. All right, so it's a system of interconnected computers, telephones, and or other communication devices that can communicate with one another and share applications and data. All right, so I gave you a picture like this. I told you that this is an example of a network. And you see, two and more computers are connected to the same devices. They use the same devices and are connected to the same internet. Okay, so with these computers joined, this is called a network. These ones are joined with cables, then this side, it's wireless, right? So this laptop, the cell phone, is connected to the same Wi-Fi, same router. These computers are connected to this PC. These desktop PCs are connected to the same server, right? So with all of this that is happening here, this is a network, right? It's a network. Remember we said a network is a system of interconnected computers, telephones, and other communication devices that can communicate with one another and share applications and data. So these devices are connected and they share the same data and the same devices. Like you can see the cell phone, laptop, they're connected to this and they share the same internet. They are connected to the internet using this device. This one's the PC, the desktop PCs are connected to the server and they share the same data. So these three PC, these three desktop PCs have access to information that is provided by the server. So this is an example of a network. All right, so today I want us to discuss the advantages of a network. Right. If I can ask, what are three advantages that you know of a network? You have seen the picture. Yesterday we have this we discussed what networks are, how they work. You have seen that. So I think you can tell me the disadvantages and the advantages of a network, but let's start with advantages, right? So anyone, the advantages of having computers connected to the same devices, of having computers using the same devices, have the same access to a device, maybe like those desktop PCs have access to information that is in the server, those the laptop, the cell phone, the laptop and cell phone and two cell phones that are connected to the same router. So the cell phone, laptop and the other cell phone are connected to the same router. They share a net, they share information, they have data access, so they share an access to the data. The three desktop PCs, they share information that is in the server. All right, so I want you to please tell me the advantages of a network. If you have any questions, please guys, please, please ask. If you don't understand, just raise your hand or say, ma'am, can you please repeat on this point? Or maybe, ma'am, please explain more. I do not understand. You are welcome. Right. Now, I want everyone to come up with advantages of a network. Lionheart. The first one is communication become easier. Communication becomes easier. Okay. What do you understand about this one? With communication becoming easy. Because people can communicate from all around the world through the network. People are connected through, they can communicate through the network. How are they connected? They have internet access. If I have internet access and someone from maybe China also has internet access, that means we are in a network. We can communicate. We can communicate. We are connected. All right, I see Lionheart says we can communicate with others without having to meet them in reality. Yes, yes, that's correct. So that's one, that's the first advantage. The second one, the second advantage. The second advantage I have five learners, eh? So I have five participants, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I have three, Lionheart, Nearly Blessed and Tyron. Is it Tyron or what? Yeah, Tyron, please forgive me if I pronounced your name incorrectly. Okay, And we also have Jaden. Jaden. And Xolo. Hi, Xolo. Hi, Xolo. All right, Jaden. Anything? Xolo? A disadvantage of a network. A disadvantage of a network. So Lionheart came up with the first one. She said we can communicate with others without having to meet them in reality, which is correct. All right, the second one, let me see if we have any response. Nothing. The second one. Information transfer. We can transfer data and information. We can copy and send information from one computer to another. We can share information. We can share information. Like this one, the desktop PCs. This ones are sharing information that is in the server. Remember the server. Okay, so the administrator here can save information on the server. And then this, the owners or the users of this desktop PCs have the same access to this server. So if there's files like of music, books, this three PCs have access to this information. They share the data that is in here. So it becomes easy to share information, because even if information is not in the server, but one user has that information, that kind of information, they can put that information in one of the PCs, and that information can be shared or made available for everyone through the server. This one can save information on the server. Also, the administrator can save information and control everything that happens here. And then these three desktop PCs, they have the same access. So that's the second advantage of a network. It's easy to share information. Information can be shared between computers, from one computer to another, easily. All right. So we said the first one is communication becomes easier. The second one, sharing of data and information becomes easy, because one computer, information from one computer can be shared or copied to the next computer, right? Let me see. Hi, Nelly Blessed. Okay, so Nelly is saying security is good. Users cannot see other users' files, and unlike on standalone machines. Is that correct? I do not think so. Security is not that good in a network, because people can hack your stuff. People can, they can hack your accounts. All right, so Lionheart says it's cheaper to communicate on the network than having to go and waste money to meet family and friends. Yes, yes. Communication and interaction becomes easy. Don't have to travel to see someone. So communication is easy. Right? Lionheart is also saying, well, people could hack past the security. Yes, yes. So can you see, Nelly, that security is not that good, because users can hack. They can hack your accounts. They can have information that you, you thought maybe it's private. They can see your private information. So privacy not really there, right? So this is the third advantage number three. So Nelly Blessed, you are incorrect. I cannot take that answer for now, but that is a disadvantage. Please save that for disadvantages of a network. Okay, let's see. Okay, and the security could charge to give you privacy. Yes, they could. They could charge to give you privacy. And then I do not have much information with regards to the charging of security. Okay, so Lionheart, could you please explain more? Tell us more. What do you understand? What are you trying to say with security could charge to give you privacy? Please. Okay. Where's Jaden? Tolo. Ah, guys. Tolo, Jaden, come on. I know you want to say something. Just feel free. Okay. The next one is access to hardware devices. Remember yesterday I even made an example of a printer. Say we are three people, each person has their own laptop, maybe a laptop or just a PC, a desktop, a desktop PC, like the example on the screen. Can you see these three desktop PCs? These PCs share the same devices, like these three, the laptop and two PCs share the same device. Three laptops or three computers can also share one device, like a printer. So I do not have to to buy my own printer. If we are three, we are in the office or we are at home, we can use one printer. So a network helps us by saving. We don't have to buy more devices, we buy just one printer for everyone, one router for everyone to connect. Let's see your responses. Ooh, Lionheart. Okay, so Lionheart is saying, well, if you want privacy, let's say from people looking at your stuff on the network, some securities can charge to protect your stuff on the network. Okay, all right. I have had encounters like that before. Is it? Okay, wonderful. All right, thank you very much for enlightening us, for giving us more information with regards to security and charging. Like securities, they charge to protect your stuff on the internet. Yes, thank you very much. Yes, so, okay, so I think this is our fourth or third advantage of a network. Access to hardware devices. So in a network, access to a single printer or a scanner is easily available to many people at the same time. Like I've said, if we are in an office or home, or maybe, yeah, office or home, you don't have to buy many printers. You just buy one printer for everyone to connect through a network. We do not have to buy routers, many routers, just one router that allows maybe 10 people to join, or is to join and use the same internet, to have the same internet access, right? So we don't have to buy many devices, just like the printer or the scanner. Scanner, just one scanner, so that we can all join and use that one scanner. So it saves money. Yeah. Imagine life without networks. Yo. Okay. Anything else? Something maybe you want to add on what we have on the list of the advantages of having a network? Do you want to add something? Do you want to add, Olo? Jaden, please add something. Okay. Where's Olo? Someone left. Olo left. Oh, my God. All right. Okay, so the next one, I think that's all for advantages. Okay, we still have more. Software installation. Software applications can easily be installed or upgraded from one central location. Like you see on the server, if there's a software application or application. That application can be shared. If the application is here on the server, all these users have access to that software application. So can you see how easy software can be installed or upgraded from one central location instead of upgrading a software application from this on this PC? Then imagine if there was no network, I would have to go from PC to PC upgrading, doing the same thing. So with a network, you just upgrade or install a software application from just one central location. So this is a central location. You upgrade and install a software application. Yeah, don't have to install it on the PCs, like one by one. So it makes life more easy. Okay. Lionheart, that is true. Lionheart is saying that is true. Yes. Okay. So now we also have central storage. So information and data can be stored in one place. If the information is stored on this server, all of these PCs have access to that information and data. So data and information is saved only in one place, in this central location. It doesn't have to be saved on each and every PC, or even in the laptops, the cell phones. So with the network, you can just save data and information in one central location, the central location. All right. Now we are moving to the disadvantages of a network. The disadvantages, any that you can think of, Lionheart and Jaden and Nelly. Nelly? Okay. The disadvantages of a network. Nelly said, remember about the security. Security, Nelly said, security is good. Users cannot see other users' files, unlike on standalone machines. Remember I said, there is incorrect for an advantage. But now this is a disadvantage because users can access files. They can access your information. They can see your stuff without your consent. Okay. Lionheart, viruses are bad. Viruses are bad. Okay, so let's see. That's correct. It's correct. Because in a network, let's say one computer has a virus. That virus can easily be transferred from that computer to another through an internet. So that's a disadvantage, né? Okay, let me see. All right. Phishers, worms, yes, you name them, malware, yes. There is danger of hacking with wide area networks. That's correct, Nelly. Can you see now? Correct. Also, the security, Lionheart is saying, also the security could be fake and they could also hack you. Yes, that's correct. You think that your stuff is safe, but some securities could be hackers. Yes, 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 yes. Yeah. That's true. Nelly, there's danger of hacking with wide area network. That's correct. That is correct, Nelly. Correct. Okay. So we said viruses can be easily transferred from one computer to another in a network. Yeah. So through a network, it's easy to transfer viruses. Okay. So the second disadvantage, anything that you can think of that you think is a disadvantage. Okay. Yes, Nelly has mentioned hacking, and also Lionheart. Guys have mentioned hacking. That's correct. So you can be like a network can expose a person to online crimes. Yes, such as identity theft, credit card theft, and scams. Sure. That's a disadvantage. The third one, since computers are all connected in a network, I think you have mentioned this, yes. People can try to access private and restricted information using the network. We have mentioned this already. Okay. So a network administrator has control over the network, and administers and manages usage, sorry. Okay, so an administrator can have access and control everything that happens in a network. So not everything must go up according to the administrator. Sometimes administrators do not accommodate everyone. So if I'm the administrator of this server, I delete data and information from the server without communicating with these users. Maybe someone wanted to use that data or wanted to use that information. So as an administrator, I can control and just remove data and information. Whatever I want to remove, I remove. So that's a disadvantage to the users. Nay, to the people who are using this desktop PCs. So to the people that are in the internet. That are involved in the network. All right. Now, let's see the next disadvantage. Okay, so those were my 3-4 disadvantages that I could think of with regards to the network or to networking. Anything that you want to add? Disadvantages. So, like I've said, that was just a list of potential advantages and disadvantages from my side. How do you feel about today's lesson? How do you feel? Please share with me, how do you feel about today's lesson? How do you feel? So everything has its advantages and disadvantages. It's just a way of life. That's how it is. So how do you feel about all of this? Since we have discussed the advantages and the disadvantages of a network, how do you feel? Are you still going to be interested in using or in being involved in networking, in computer networks? Are you interested? How do you feel about them? It was a good lesson, ma'am. Oh, Nelly, I'm very interested. Lionheart, Nelly, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Without you, this wasn't gonna be a good lesson. Thank you for having people like you. Thank you for having you, Lionheart. Yo, guys, you make my day. Okay, so Lionheart is saying, I'm very interested. Are you not scared? What about privacy on the internet? I mean, on the, with regards to networks, are you not scared of privacy? Of your privacy, are you not scared? Are you not concerned, maybe? But then without networks, oh, life would be boring. I can't imagine life without networking. Okay. Right, so a little, but it won't stop me. Lionheart. yeah, same. I won't stop. You can't stop, but yeah, scary. Right, so I think that's it for today. And thank you so much, guys, for joining this presentation. And I hope to see you tomorrow. Okay, Nelly, please join us tomorrow and invite more people. Nee, thanks, ma'am. Thank you, Lionheart. Thank you, Nelly. Thank you, JJ. Jaden. Thank you.